Welcome everyone to what we're anticipating will be a really closely contested cricket match here today. It's a lovely day here today and the ground looks absolutely fantastic. There are a few empty seats, but I'm sure they'll fill up as the day progresses. I can see the captains are waiting to toss the coin, so let's get down there and see what happens. Tony Gregg has made the long climb up to the commentary box. You had a close look at the pitch earlier, Tony. How did it look?
Well, Jonathan.
This could be a good contest. This is a good competitive wicket with a little bit for both the batsman and the bowler. He's picked his spot well there.
And that brings up the first boundary of the innings. That wasn't far away from the edge of the bat. That's raced away through. He picked the length really early there. No run there. Good bowling from the left armour. His captain won't be too happy with that. The leg spinner to start a new spell. That should go all the way to the boundary. That clattered into the hoardings. That's gone way into the stand. 6 runs. He hit that with great power. He's got hold of that. The fielder hardly had a chance to move. He's gone for it, and he gets 6. He's certainly not hanging around.
Great shot. He got into a perfect position for that shot. Head over the ball, weight forward.
That's two sixes off the over now. That's four all the way. A beautifully timed shot for four. The off-spinner to start a new spell. Oh, well held by that spectator. That was six all the way. That was an excellent. That was sheer brute force. That easily cleared the boundary. No run there. No run taken off that ball. Runs off the over in double figures. Here comes the first change in bowling.
That's good batting. He might have hit it in the air, but was pretty safe. It got him four more.
He found the gap with precision.
He had a big swing at that one, but missed everything.
Everyone had to take cover in the stand there. That came right off the meat of the bat. Beautiful timing. It's been a rather expensive over so far. The crowd applaud a great knock.
He's played wonderfully out there and really deserves the applause.
He's gone.
That was an absolute aberration. What was he thinking?
And from another angle? New batsman in for Australia. That's an appalling number. And we have a change of bowling. That's raced away for four.
That was beautifully put away for four.
He didn't play that one very well. Six. Batsman was all at sea there. That's the end of another over. The off-spinner to start a new spell. Just one run.
That's really demoralising for the bowler, but he needs to bounce back quickly.
He might have got a hand to that, but he couldn't stop it. Really is very disappointing for the bowler.
That is definitely not good cricket. A momentary lapse of concentration has cost him his wicket.
I'm sure the new batsman will look to play himself in. How much has the test game changed since you were playing international cricket, Tony?
I don't think it's changed that much. I think there are a few aspects of it that are a little different, in so much as I think the one-day game has created more of a sense of urgency in test cricket. We see a lot of test matches these days finished in sometimes 3 days and quite often 4 days, where they used to go 5 days. So the aggressive nature of the game, I think, has changed a bit. Most of the other aspects of it are the same. Fielding's improved, I've no doubt about that, again, because of the one-day format. And I think that the other thing that clearly has changed is that there's such a difference between the Australians, who are world champions by miles and have been for far too long, and everyone else. And that's a bit of a shame, because I think most people in the world of cricket like to see competitive cricket, and unfortunately that's not happening at the moment.
Well, this is developing into a fascinating contest.
That had four written all over it from the moment it left his bat.
4 all the way. No run taken off that ball. Nice shot.
Super shot, he really punished the bowler there.
Very wild over so far. That really is an expensive over. No runs off that delivery. Dot ball. Nothing scored there.
You just can't afford to bowl too many no balls in a one-day game.
No run scored. No runs there. A very good over, only one off it in the end. The quick bowler to start a new spell. Big shout. He was beaten all ends up by that one. Another run onto the scoreboard.
That's the perfect length for this wicket. Bring the batsman onto the front foot.
That was a mighty hit. Thin edge. That's the end of another over. We're going to see a change of bowlers now. Umpire signalling a no ball.
The batsman definitely had a bit of luck there. I don't know how that missed the stumps.
Out, bowled. That is a superb delivery. Let's have a look at that again. Serious pressure on new man in there. Facing Lillian Thompson must have been an eye-opening experience, Tony, but would it have changed much if you'd been afforded the protective equipment used today?
Well, I mean, first of all, it needs to be noted that they were one of the reasons why that protective equipment came about, because I was one of the first people that actually started to... I mean, I think also it's got a bit to do with age. You know, if you combine facing Lillian Thompson with about 32 years of age, then we're all looking for a bit of protection. It does make a difference, there's no doubt about that. I'm not sure that it makes you a better player. It is comforting to know that you're not going to be killed. I mean,
the fast bowler to start a new spell. No run taken off that ball. No run scored. That's out.
That was a fairly straightforward catch, but you still need to make sure of it.
Let's have a look at the action replay. So, left-hand, right-hand pairing at the crease now. Big appeal. Good stuff from the fast bowler. That's one more onto the score.
He plays that shot really well and it brings him a lot of runs.
We're going to see a change of bowlers now. No run there. Got ball.
He's got the edge.
Batsmen change their minds. He's certainly not hanging around.
Oh, that's close.
The umpire isn't having any of it.